Right, it's time to put in the grassy areas now. And again, I'll go back to the large brush and we'll mix it soft green. And I'll just stipple down here, look. Pushing the edge of this brush to shape, because I want to go across here. We'll use a little mask again so we can go across there, look. Bit of yellow hansa with a bit of white, I want this lighter. We'll use a mask here, look, to down to here. All I'm doing is stippling, look. Down to the bottom edge. Now, we'll do the other side. And then we're putting some details. Starting with a light green. These larger brushes speed up the painting process. One of the biggest problems that beginners have is that the paint brushes that are far too small. This is my stippler that I'm using. 1-inch stippler. Well, I've killed a few midges here, haven't I? Right, now I want some darker greens. You'll notice my brush strokes are following the lay of the land. They're coming down at a slight angle. Just blocking this area in here. Same on the other side. When you're stippling, basically what you're doing, you're knocking nails in, so you've got to keep putting the brush back to shape. But I'm not painting too wet, you'll notice. Otherwise the paint will skid all over the canvas, and I don't want that. So there's the underpainting put on. What we need to do now is to soften this area. So I'm going to use the 3/4 brush. I want to shape the path. So I'm using a bit of Payne's Grey and a bit of burnt sienna. The path's going around there in the distance, look. It's coming out there. I'm just roughing the shape out. I'll do something with it. The line is coming out here. A bit coming there. Right, let's go to the small rigger brush and we'll just twitch that up like that and blend that in to get rid of the harsh line. I want a softer bit here at the edge of the path. What you've got to learn is how wet the paint on the brush should be. Not too wet, but it's got to be able to move. Just blending that in like that. Same thing over this side. Just blend that in. So we've got the underpainting on now. We'll put some texture in the grass and we'll put the path in. But we need to let this dry first. I've decided to put the path in next and we're going to use a 3/4 brush and I want a bit of white and some raw sienna to start with. And we're going to just have a good wiggle look. I want lighter in the distance. Just wiggling the brush as I come forward. Right, now I want a bit of purple, a bit of red, a bit of blue, and a bit of white. And I'm going to go along here. I want it a bit dark, a bit more blue. I'm just going to use that to outline the path. A bit darker now, a bit more Payne's Grey to the mix. That's better. Just using the side of the brush and blending that in. Right, I'm going to use the small brush now. Payne's Grey, Rose Sienna. I'm going to just add a bit of dark here and there. And up the middle of the path, just going to add a bit of variety like that. Just to lead the eye up the path. Darken this out here a bit. I'm going to use a knife to scratch in a few little impressions of stones, which you always get in a path like this. You can paint these in, but you can scratch them in quite easily. Right, we need to do something with this grass area now. So we're going to use my special tree brushes. I'm going to use the angled one, and I'm going to put some light areas in. So I'm just going to stipple up like that. I'm using yellow light Hansa, a little bit of orange azo and some white. Just coming down like that, look. To put some light areas. This is the kind of thing I do when I go out painting. Proper painting takes me about 2 hours. This is a quick sketch with a modern camera, the digital camera. You can take some effective photographs, and when you get home you can sit in your studio and turn it into a really good painting. What I'm trying to show you is a variety of techniques. Just trying to get some texture, some variety in this grass area. Grass isn't just green, there's all sorts of colours in. The shadows reflected from the sky, tree, anything surrounding around it, the trees. Switching to the round brush now. I'm going to put some little lighter coloured flowers in. Just touching very, very gently. Turner and Constable always used to put a few bits of red in here and there. Opposite colours on the colour wheel, red and green. So I think we'll do the same. Bit of raw sienna around the top there. Right, we're nearly there. Make this tree more distinctive. Few more highlights in these trees over here. Now the paint is dried. Within a few seconds we're going to put some of those lemons I've been telling you about earlier, just to put some figures in. Just want to lighten these trees here. Right, I'm going to put a few pink flowers in here just to add a bit of variety. So I'll use a bit of red, a bit of white. We don't want them too red. They're not poppies, they're just red flowers that you get. Just going up and down, putting a few little pinkies in. Put a few pinks in there. Right, let's put the fence in. Now when you're painting fences, the distance between the fence posts wants to be twice the height of the fence. We don't want the painting ruined with square fences. We know fences are nice and straight and 3 and 4 bar, but not in a painting. We want rough looking fences. I'm going to make the painting a little more distinctive now. The fence, I'm just going to put some dark bits on the fence like that. These are just the little finishing things that we need to do. And then we're going to mix some Payne's Grey with some red. Lizard crimson. I want a nice weak wash. And we're going to add a bit of depth in these trees. Just going to wiggle like this. Just lash it on and rub it around like that, look, with a rigger. Just to add some depth, because trees are dark on the inside. These are little finishing detail is important. When you've done your painting, whether it's a watercolour with acrylics or one painted on canvas, it's a good idea to go along to your local black and white copier and take a copy of it. If your painting comes out all grey, your painting's not right. The most important thing in a painting is the relationship between the lights and the darks. That's paramount. So I'm just putting a bit in there, a bit more in here, a bit more in here. I want a bit in this tree here, look, just dab, 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 dab. These finishing things are so important. Some people call it fiddling. To me, it's the fiddling that makes the painting. So I'll make no excuses for it. Right, I'm going to just press this around. I've dipped the rigger in water. And I'm just going to phase that darker colour out by just scumbling, it's called. Technical term for it. And that's given more depth to that tree line. Right, we're going to finish now by putting in a couple of figures. This is only a quick sketch. We're going to put in some figures now. And we're going to do them red. So we're going to paint a lemon shape. We'll put them here, look. There's the shape of a lemon. And we'll have a blue one, I think. Put the legs on. They're walking, so we'll just bend it a little bit. Little head on like that. This one's got a backpack on. This one's got a stick. There we are. Bit of shadow underneath them, very important. And the final thing is we're going to just pick out the shape of this path. These little bits of distinction here and there are so important. One bit over here and we finished. That needs softening. And there's our finished painting. Hope you enjoyed watching me paint that. Do have a go. I'm sure you'll enjoy painting it. Happy painting. See you next time.
Now available to buy. Try these techniques at home whenever you wish. The DVD of today's workshop and the book that accompanies this series are now available to order from the Painting and Drawing channel. For further information and to order your copy, go to www.paintingdrawingchannel.com.